Hey everybody, it's Jason Blaha here, and today I want to chat with you guys a little bit about setting up speed work and how someone could go about setting up dynamic effort days and speed days if they don't have bands or chains. Now, I've made the point before that everyone should have bands, but maybe it's just not logistically or practically possible for you. There could be reasons for it. So let's say you were going to do just straight barbell stuff. Well, what you pretty much need is a bench press, a sumo deadlift, and a box squat. Now, you can do this when people say, well, how do I set up my percentages? Well, what you need to remember is that what you are usually shooting for is somewhere between 2 or 3 reps. And I think 2 to 3 works best for speed work. And I've experimented with singles, I've experimented with 5s, and even a lot of the West Side guys have. But ultimately, 2s and 3s work. People say, well, why? Because what you're looking for, ideally, is for your total reps of your speed set to equal about the same amount of speed and time involved with a 1 rep max. So in other words, if it takes you 3 seconds to lock out a max squat, you probably want about 3 seconds of lifting time. Okay, so in other words, if you can do 1.5 second speed reps, about 2 of those is about perfect. So there's the reason for it. Basically, you're trying to create maximum force for around the same amount of time that a decent max would be, a true max. Trying to apply maximum speed and force for the same total amount of time. So what we would generally look at is 2 to 3 reps. And what I would say a good starting point, because you do speed work in 3-week waves, right? We do speed work in 3-week waves. Usually going up 5% in weight each time. Now that's 5% of your max, not 5% of bar weight. Usually about 60% for raw is a good starting point. So in other words, for your box squat, about 60% of your max box squat. For your sumo deadlift, about 60% of your max sumo deadlift. All right, you could work with weights that are 60%, then you go 65 in the second wave, and then 70%. So let's say you're going to do 10 doubles. Week 1, you would do, let's say your max is 400 pounds, right? 60% of that. It's going to be about 240. You would do 240 for 10 doubles with short breaks between. And I'm talking 60 to 90 seconds tops. Well, high work density. And that's all you need to recover from that. Because you're only doing 2 reps with 60% of your max. If you can lift 400 pounds, doing 2 reps with 240 as fast as you can isn't going to be very taxing. Because technically, you should be able to do probably close to 15 reps, just a ballpark, at least 15 reps as it is with that weight. So doing 20 for speed isn't going to be too fatiguing. You're not going to be reaching muscle failure. Now, the idea is to recover just enough that you can explode again. And usually that takes a minimum of 30 seconds, a minimum of 30 seconds, up to about 60. So that's a good ballpark, about 60 seconds, 90 seconds at the very, very most. So you do them in that time frame, and you would come in and do 240 for the first wave, week 1. 10 doubles. Week 2, you go up 5%, so you go to 65%. Okay, 65%. It's going to be about 260. Do 260 for 10 doubles with about a minute between. Exploding as hard and as fast as you can. Week 3 would be your heaviest wave. You go to 70%. Again, we do the math the same way. It's going to be about 280 pounds, right? If your max is 400, 70% of that. All right, we just created a 3-week pendulum wave, and you could do that for bench press. You could do it for a box squat. You could do it for sumo deadlift. Now, we pick variations that are easy to recover from, okay, that have predetermined ranges of motion. So that's why we want to do a box squat. Box squat has the highest rate of force production of any squat. And we have an exact set range of motion, and we can explode from it. Sumo deadlift is the easiest deadlift to recover from. Puts the least shear on your spine. That's why we can do higher volumes with it. And because those two variations are wider stance, we get better lower body muscular development and mobility and everything else. right? So that's why we do them that way. So people would say, okay, so you're supposed to rotate them. Aren't you supposed to do waves where you do bands and then change? Yeah, you could do that. You could do that. Your other option, because you can't do that, because that's what you're supposed to do. So what are your other options? You could do a lift variation, or you could use repetition work. You do repetition work. You could come in and do six sets of six instead of compensatory acceleration. We're now picking a weight that's challenging, and you try to add weight through each of the waves, even if it's a tiny amount, because now we're training for strength. We can't do the big jumps, because you might be working with something that's like your seven rep max. Okay, it's going to be a little heavier. You come in and do a 6x6, which is what some guys do for repetition work. I said you could do that for a three-week wave and try to PR, even if it's micro-loading, even if you just add micro-plates. You could do a 6x6 for a three-week wave. Now, deadlifts, that might be a little harder. You'd always bring those down a little less. Or you could do another variation. You could change your stuff 1 inch. You could go to a 1 inch deeper box. You could go to a 1 inch deficit sumo. You could go to a 1 inch block pull. In fact, you got different ranges of motion with all of these. Right, you could have three different box heights. You could run three different waves or two different waves based upon box heights, upon pulling heights, to where you have a variation. It's not going to be as big of a contrast as switching from bands to chains back and forth. Not going to be as big of a contrast, but you could do it. And it's workable. People say, what about bench press? Well, that one's a little tougher, isn't it? A little tougher. You do different grip widths. Now, you don't want to be doing ultra-wide anyways, but you could do medium grip and you could do close grip. And you could do a different bench variation. Now, I wouldn't necessarily go floor press. People say, what about floor press? Well, because you are losing some range of motion, and this is speed work. Maybe not ideal. Could you do an incline bench? Sure. Could you do a decline bench? You could do that. That would be a different variation. What about if you really wanted, could you do a wave of doing the standing press? Now, I don't program that for anybody. There are certainly people who do it. You could do the strict press, standing press. You do speed work with that. That's doable. So you have alternative variations of these lifts you could do to where you can change them. You could go to a different form of press for the bench. But box squats and sumo deadlifts, you can always change the height. You can change the range of motion an inch either direction. And in fact, if you really wanted to have some variation in your waves because you don't have the stark contrast of the bands and chains, you could have three different variations. You could have a standard sumo, you could have a 1 inch block pull, and you could have a 1 inch deficit, and you could rotate through those. Through three-week waves. Same thing with your box squat. You could have three different box heights an inch apart. You could have a parallel box. You could have an inch below parallel, and you could have 2 inches below parallel, which might be represented by, you know, in my case, that would be a 13, a 12, and an 11-inch box. You could do that for variations. You have options. It's all viable for speed work. Or, like I said, your other alternative, you could rotate in 3 week waves of speed work and then 3 week waves of heavier, moderate rep work, right? Like represented as a 6x6. Now, some people would say possibly a 5x5 for lower body and 6x6 for upper. That's an option. Okay, so then you're just doing more of a rep work with heavy weight to replace the speed work. Now, I wouldn't necessarily jump in. Some people say, well, can you just do straight high rep stuff? Well, maybe, but that's going to interfere to some extent with your main training because you're going to be doing a lot of that on max effort days. Still want to get a different rep range so that we can use concurrent training a little more effectively. Those are definitely options. They're options worth considering. Remember, you don't necessarily need the same amount of exercise variation here that you do for max effort. Your conjugate lifts cover the real massive variation. We just need subtle variation. And it's totally workable. You could do this with straight weight, with no bands, no chains, no real special equipment. This requires nothing but normal benches, normal barbells, normal plates, maybe a few rubber mats and things, or pads. That's really all you need to make it work. So it's pretty straightforward. All right, guys, but that's really all I have to say on that today. I hope it's been informative, and I will talk to you guys next time.